put that off till cooler weather. Miss Rosemary's supposed to raise a paper on William Blake tonight.
Oh, dead. Oh, it's from Keith. Mrs. Baskett, everybody, this is how I feel about the verse play. It is far too important a thing to be read under any but ideal circumstances. Not only atmospheric on some cool night with music playing to go with it, but when everyone is present so that no one might miss it. Why don't we,
Why don't we take a stand and vote on the matter?
Good, good. Perfect.
All in favor of putting the verse play off to a cooler weather? Stand up.
Was this a vote?
Now, Mrs. Bassett, no rough tactics.
Oh, does everyone have a plan? John, I have a problem. The poet William Blake.
Insane, insane. That man was a mad fanatic.
Now, Mrs. Bassett.
This is a free country. I can speak my opinion, and I have read up on him.
Go on, Rosemary. I wasn't criticizing your pain.
Mrs. Bassett's only joking, Rosemary. No, I'm not giving you anything. She feels that strongly about it.
Not a bit. Don't be silly. I just don't see why we should encourage the writings of people like that who've already gone into a drunkard's grave.
Oh, is he dead? I never heard that about him.
Mrs. Bassett is mistaken. Mrs. Bassett, you confused Blake with somebody else.
Oh, no, don't tell me. I know what I'm talking about. I read up on him. He traveled around with that Frenchman and took a shot at him.
Dear.
They landed them both in jail? Brussels. Brussels?
Brussels sprouts.
That's where it happened. Took a shot at him in a drunken stupor, and later one of them died of TB in the gutter.
All right, I won't say anything more. Go on, Rosemary. Nothing like contact culture.
Before Rosemary reads her paper on William Blake, I think it would be a good idea, since some of us are not acquainted with Blake's work, to start preface the critical and biographical comments with a reading of one of his loveliest lyrical poems.
I'm not going to read anything, not I.
Well, then I shall, then. This is called Love's Secret. Never seek to tell thy love, love that never told can be. For the gentle wind doth move, silently, invisibly. I told my love, I told him all my heart. Trembling cold with ghastly fear, did my love depart. No sooner had he gone from me, than a stranger passing by, silently, invisibly, took him with a sigh.
Honey, that was not the man I meant. I was thinking about the one who wrote about the white, red lips. Now, who was it that wrote about the white, red lips?
John?
Well, I have to call on a patient.
Oh, John!
The poet William Blake was born in 1757.
Of poor but honest parents.
No supercilious comments out of you, sir. Go on, Rosemary, such a beautiful voice.
Everyone, please excuse the interruption. Dr. Buchanan had to call on a patient.
Oh, and I bet I know who that patient was. That Gonzales girl, whose father owns the Moonlight Casino and always has a pistol strapped to his belt.
Poor Johnny Buchanan's gonna get himself shot in that crowd.
Oh, Mrs. Bassett, where did you get that idea? I don't think John even knows the Gonzales girl.
Oh, he knows her all right in the biblical sense of the word, if you'll excuse me.
Oh, not excuse you. Such a thing is inexcusable.
Have you fallen?
Miss Almond's fallen for the young doctor. You know, I heard he has many new lady patients.
Stop it! I will not have Melissa smoke in this house! Oh, you all scared him out of here after I bragged to him about how bright and interested you all were. Put your worst foot forward and sleep with a chair and carry on like idiots! Idiots! What am I saying? Please excuse me.
I'll move that the meeting adjourned.
I second the motion. Poor Miss Alma.
She hasn't been herself lately.
I don't understand what happened.
You couldn't. You wouldn't want me.
This happened because of his devotion to you.
This happened because some meddlesome man called him in here tonight. Who was it did that?
I did.
So it was you then?
Yes, I called him in here the moment I heard what you were planning. I told him to come here and stop it.
You called him here to be shot!
You can't blame this on anything but your
weakness.
You call me weak?
Sometimes it takes a tragedy like this to make a weak person strong.
You white-blooded spinster! You so right, people! Pious, pompous mumblers! Preachers and preachers' daughters! All muffled up in a lot of burnout magic! And I was supposed to minister your neurosis! Give you tablets for sleeping and tonics to give you the strength! So that you can go on mumbling your worn-out mumbo-jumbo.
Call me what you like, but don't let your father hear your drunken shouting.
Come here. I want you to look at something. This chart of anatomy, look!
I've seen it before!
You've never dared to look at it!
Why should I?
Because you're scared!
It doesn't matter!
That's your mistake! You think you're stuffed with rose leaves? Turn around and look at it. It might do you good!
How can you behave like this with your father dying?
Hold still!
Have you so much to blame for it?
No more than you are!
At least within a little while!
Look here!
You can feel some shame!
Listen here to the anatomy lecture! This upper story is the brain, which is hungering for something called truth. And it doesn't get much, but it keeps on feeling hungry. This story here is the belly. Oh, and this part down here is the sex, which is hungry for love, because sometimes it's lonesome. I fed all three, as much as all three as I could have, or as much as I wanted. You've fed none. Well, maybe your belly a little. Lottery substance. But love or truth? Nothing but hand-me-down notions, attitudes, poses. You can go now. The anatomy lecture is over.
So that is your high conception of human desire. What you have here is not the anatomy of a beast, but of man. I disagree with you about what kind of truth you believe the brain to be seeking and where love is, for there is something not shown on that chart.
You mean the part that Alma is famed for, do you?
Yes. It's there, not shown, but it is there all the same. And it is that I love you with, Jane. Yes, did love you with, to nearly die of when you hurt me.
I wouldn't have made love to you.
What?
The night at the casino, I wouldn't have made love to you. Even if you had consented to go upstairs, I couldn't have made love to you. Yes, yes, isn't that funny? I'm more afraid of your soul than you're afraid of my body. You would have been as safe as the angel on the fountain, because I wouldn't have felt decent enough to touch you.
It's resting more easily now.
It's cold.
It's all right.
I'll hear it.
Alma, Dr. John asked for you. He asked if you could sing for him.
I couldn't now.
Go in and sing to him, Miss Alma.